Yeah, smiling faces in the sun during training camp. How come? How is that possible? Still, it is possible. We are joined now by Yulin, by Ashley, and by Anna, of course, our world champion. Yulin, considering we have now a Belgian sponsor, is everyone learning a bit of Flemish already?
Yeah, I'm teaching them some Flemish words.
How is that working out for you, Ashley?
Heel goed.
Oh yeah. That's almost Afrikaans, right?
Afrikaans part.
That's true. Do you do that? Do you often speak Afrikaans, Dutch? Do you
know a bit too, Jolien. She understands me the best. The Dutch don't understand me as well.
Yeah, Ashley can understand me better than the Dutch can understand me. So
that is interesting. Of course, yeah. How come?
I don't know.
Belgian is a bit Afrikaans.
I don't see the problem. Yeah.
No. There is no problem at all. sitting in the center here in Oudenaarde, with the Nieuwsblad coming up, does that motivate you extra? This is the season. This is my last season as well. So that brings something extra.
Yeah. Just every time I come here, riding on the cobbles, it's always excited. Even today on the recon, I was so happy to be back. Not in the Spanish hills anymore, but just on the flat on the cobbles. And yeah, that's what I like.
But with the Spanish sun, though.
Yeah, with the Spanish sun, so that's special.
So you're looking forward very much to this last season for you.
Yeah, it's my last season.
That's a definite decision, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you sure?
Yeah,
for sure. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think about it that much. Like a lot of media journalists said it to me today, but I'm just busy with this season, and I'm not counting down or anything. So I'm just enjoying every race, every training. And
but don't you think you will do, standing on a podium at the start of a race, that you say maybe, okay, this is my last one in my career?
Yeah, maybe, you never know, but not right now. I'm just looking forward to race again, to have fun with the team. I'm not thinking that much, so yeah.
Okay, how does that work with you then, Anna? Are you thinking, okay, this is the last team presentation for me? You're happy about that, right?
With everything I do, I think it's the last time I have to do it. No.
No, that's not true.
No, it's not true, and I think it's also, it's not really good if you think like that all the time. I mean, you should enjoy the last thing, but it's also like we're used to do it. And like Yulin said, the focus now is on the racing. And maybe you have some moments that you think, this was my last one, probably.
But would that give you some feelings of sadness as well? Or is it more cheerful, like,
maybe
glad that's over?
Maybe sometimes, because it's, yeah, you cannot do it over again. Normally it's like, okay, I did it. If you do something
we'll
wrong,
be back.
I can do better next time. Well, that's not counting for us. So I think that's also motivating, sort of.
Mm. How do you feel?
Good.
Good. How was training camp?
Nice.
Very nice.
Yeah.
What does that mean towards the races we're facing?
Well, it's always a bit exciting after winter, especially because the team changed a lot with a lot of new girls.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to find out how everybody is. You need to get to know each other. And that's always pretty nice to have a team camp. And it's quite difficult now to get it done, to have all the corona tests, to be together in one place. So, I think Danny did it pretty well. We had a good team camp too, actually.
What did he do pretty well? That bonding, the trying to make it a team?
Also, but I think this season the first step is to get everybody in the place we need to be. That's quite a challenge already. So,
are you in place already?
Well, I was in Spain with everybody. So that was good. And I think it's a nice team. We had some good time to get to know each other, to race against each other, with each other.
But for instance, with Ashley, you rode against her for many years. Do you get to know each other much more? What did you not know before? And now you know, after you've been to training camp together.
It's like, now I know. I'm not gonna tell, of course.
Secrets.
Yeah.
We have secrets.
I've shared rooms with Ashley, so like you say, it's nice to finally be together in one team. It's always, we were like one of the biggest concurrents.
Yeah.
And now you can share stories and say things like, yeah, you remember that race, you did this and this. And that's fun, you know? It's like we can work together now. So I can share all my secrets and Ashley can tell hers to me. And then, yeah, hopefully we have some nice racing together and you're not the concurrent anymore, but you have to work together. And I think that feeling is really nice to have it in the winter period, to not only with Ashley, of course, with all the teammates.
Right. And but still, Ashley, because I could imagine riding against the team that makes you the leader of your former team. Now you have several leaders. How does that work?
Well, I think that's a really unique point of this team. And I think that that's something that Danny does particularly well. So, you know, when he approached me to join the team, for me, it was a no-brainer. It didn't take me long to make the decision.
Because why?
It's just, you know, it's always been the top team in the world. And just to, for all the years that I've watched it from the outside, you know, the way they go about racing, the way they really race so well as a team, and it's not necessarily about one leader in particular. It's about having the strongest team and then to have the numbers in the final and to be able to play different cards. And I think that's what makes this team so exciting and a big reason why I joined the team.
And can you, as a rider, even develop, you think?
For sure. I mean, I'm actually the oldest rider on the team.
But you're riding not as long maybe as
exactly.
Many others.
I only started later in life. I only discovered cycling while I was at university. So I come from quite a different background. You know, I studied before I started cycling. And
so there's lots of energy left in your body.
Yeah, so I feel I can still learn a lot in this team. And though, you know, although Anna's been, you know, my competitor for many years, now to be on her team and to be able to learn a lot from her already, you know, just in discussions like she mentioned about, oh, you remember this race, you remember you did that. You know, it's really nice to be able to have that opportunity to
discuss. So she's already a group coach, a leader, which she will be in the future here.
Exactly, and that's what makes her an amazing person and an amazing rider. She's really, you know, when she's on the bike and she's in the race, she's hungry to win, but she's also available to her teammates to help them, to give them advice, to support them, and to work for them as well. So that's what makes her an amazing leader.
That's nice. What are your big goals for this season?
Well, first goals would be Ardennes Classics. You know, I also love the classics. Belgium is a special place to race. So Ardennes Classics, in particular, the Flèche Wallonne. It's, I think, my favorite race.
There's a competitor there.
Yeah, exactly.
How are you going to do this? Because she won it 100 times or more.
Exactly. Well, I can learn a lot from her, right?
That's it. Stick to the wheel.
Exactly. Oh, yeah.
And then go over it.
And then go over it. I didn't mention that. I didn't mention that yet. Yeah. But that is possible. Yeah, of course, yeah, but that's true. Because especially within the Ardennes Classics with the Amstel Gold Race and Liège and Flèche Wallonne, you have so many riders able to win these races, or maybe three at least.
I think Flèche Wallonne is a little bit different because it's quite a specific finish. But yeah, I mean, racing in Belgium is super special. I mean, Belgium is the heart of cycling, you know, and always to race here is special, and even more special now that we have a Belgium sponsor. So yeah, I mean, that's what makes racing exciting, that there can be different finishes, different winners, different stories, you know, so yeah.
Yeah. Julien, I guess the Olympics makes it very special this year to end up your career. What would be best for you, winning Flanders or getting the gold with Lotte, for instance, in the Olympics in Tokyo?
Actually, it's a hard one. It's a hard question. But I think the Olympics, yeah.
Why is that?
Olympic medal or Olympic gold is like the highest.
Even a medal is higher rated for you than winning Flanders? Silver? Silver? Gold?
Close. I don't know.
I don't know.
No, but a medal at the Olympics is like the highest you can achieve. And I think that's the highest goal you can have as a sportsman or sportswoman. Mm-hmm. So even higher than Tour of Flanders. Mm.
And how can you combine those, the road and the Olympics on the track? Which are even still a bit uncertain.
Yeah, I think it's pretty easy to combine those two because I'm doing the medicine and it's pretty similar to the road. So I think you need to have a road background or the road preparation before you going to the Olympics for the medicine. So I think it's a good balance to have.
Are you talking to Amy already about that medicine? Because she will be your competitor there for the medal, I guess.
Every day.
No. How does that go?
No.
Not at all.
So, sometimes we talk about it, but it's not like it feels not like we're competitors. It's we feel like we're teammates, and we will see in Tokyo.
That's true. And where will you be sitting a year from now, you guess? What will you be doing?
Not here. I don't know.
Will you be riding a bike, you guess? You think of that sometimes?
Maybe not for a while. Maybe an electric bike. But,
electric bike? No kidding.
Yeah. But yeah, I don't know. We will see. I have no plans we'll see. Yeah,
he already has one.
Electric bike? You already have an electric bike?
With a basket.
No kidding.
Yeah.
But when you do groceries, you go with the electric bike?
Yeah.
We got to film that one day. That's for sure. You have an electric bike?
No.
Do you?
Well, I also own a cycling tourism business, so we have an electric bike, but it's not mine, no.
Okay, it's going to be an interesting season. Well, that's good. It's going to be an interesting season, right? The 2021 season for all of you, for different reasons. You look forward the most to the end?
No, I think this season for the Olympic Games. Probably the highlight, but maybe just as much also for the rest of the racing, just realizing it's the last time. Like Jolien, and enjoy it with this team.
That's true, yeah. What will be your highlight of the year, you guess?
Well, just being part of this team, I think we're going to have many highlights. Olympic Games, I hope it happens, because after such a challenging year with COVID, I think it would be a really amazing, ability, to bring people together to watch the games.
We hope so, yeah. That will be for you the same, right?
Yeah. Their dance as well. No.
Your dance as well?
No.
You're going to hate their dance.
Just Olympics and and the spring in general.
Yeah. You're going to ride their dance with your electric bike probably one day.
Yeah. Even then I cannot follow, I
think. that is okay. Thank you so much, ladies. And best of luck in this very interesting season, 2021. I almost forgot, but here I am, because you have been Twittering or Instagramming or what else are Facebooking a lot with the hashtag team As They Works. We have three winners with a signed shirt of As They Works. These are Lianne Bogers, Matthew Mitchell, and Marjolein Scholten. Congratulations, you have that great shirt. Wear it with proud, and thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you have a great season. Hopefully, post-COVID, we'll see each other alongside the road somewhere. Thank you very much, ladies. Thank you for watching. Bye.